We've now seen how a signal gets through the console from the input to the output, with many options for processing and routing along the way. Now let's see where the signals go after the console. First, we see how digital consoles have flexible output routing. Then we look at systems processors, which have crossovers and speaker protection. And we see how an amplifier boosts line-level signal to speaker-level. Analog consoles have a dedicated physical connector for each output. Like the main outputs and aux sends each have XLR connectors, or quarter-inch jacks, that are always dedicated to that output. But most digital consoles have outputs that are flexible, so we can assign any output to any connector. For example, in the console software, we could patch, say, the aux sends for the monitors out of outputs 1 through 4, and the main mix out of 11 and 12. Then those XLR outputs on the back of the console can be connected to the speaker system. The monitors on 1 through 4 go to the wedges, or in-ear monitors, and the main mix on 11 and 12 is sent to the main speakers. Now, all speaker systems need some processing, and this can get a little complicated, and we go into more detail in other courses. But we often control the speakers with a system processor, which has two main functions, crossover and speaker protection. A crossover splits the signal into separate frequency bands, like lows, mids, and highs. Since all speakers are made to reproduce specific frequency ranges, this lets the right frequencies go to the right speakers. And for speaker protection, we use a limiter, which is a compressor with a really high ratio, and this provides a kind of brick wall that the signal can't pass. Now, this makes sure a super hot signal doesn't come and overload the speaker and destroy it. After the system processing, we need to power the speakers, which requires a really strong signal. We get this from an amplifier, which takes a line-level signal and boosts it to speaker level. And even with small powered speakers like these QSC ones I have here, we still need all the processing. It's just built right into the actual speaker. They still use a crossover, limiter, and amplifier, but they take a line-level signal directly from the mixing console. In this video, we looked at the flexible output routing of digital consoles and talked about system processors and amplifiers.